Bonjour, j'espère que vous allez bien. Moi, je vais très très bien. Youpi, c'est lundi, c'est la forme. Alors, je vais dire bonjour à tout le monde. So I will say hello to everybody as usually. So Vuslat est là, bonjour. Luciana Moribé est là, Sundar est là, Tamika est là, Muskan, bonjour. Fiona Adams, bonjour. Yossi est avec nous, coucou Yossi. Omar est là, Jamie est avec nous, Victoria Possé aussi, bonjour, Rupa est là, Victoria Jacques, bonjour, Lisbeth, Bickert, Cosmina Bellou est là aussi, Vercingétorix, Renato est là aussi, Yessero bien sûr, Fiona Adams, Stardust est là aussi. Eh bien écoutez, bonjour à tous, je ne sais pas s'il y en a d'autres, en tout cas vous êtes les bienvenus. Patricia est là, Yasmine bonjour, Johan est là aussi, Sundar et Lisbeth. Ben écoutez, ça me fait très très plaisir de vous retrouver. I'm really happy to see you again, and I hope you're ready because we will start right now. Alors, très bien. Lanora, bonjour. Jezebel, bonjour aussi. So remember, before we start, it's the classic, but still, remember that it would be great to have another tab open, and then you can put a dictionary. So we'll see quite many verbs today. So maybe this dictionary could be useful for you to find verbs, because at one point I will quiz you, and it's always good to be quite proactive. So you can try to find the verbs like that. So we've been listing so far these verbs, dictionaries, wordreference.com, deeple.com, Collins Dictionary, and then Larousse. .fr and Google Translate if you prefer. D'accord? So open that in a new tab and it will be much faster that way. So I guess you're ready because now we're starting. Alors, keep in mind that my objective is to have at least 100 likes. It might be challenging because you're not a lot today. But we'll see. Let's see how many likes we will get. Allez, the question of the day. La première chose que vous allez faire quand le virus aura disparu, ce sera quoi? So the first thing that you're going to do when the virus will be gone, so what will this thing be? Qu'est-ce que ce sera? Remember, I just would like one little sentence in French. And you have 1 minute. Allez-y, merci. Alors, Tamika is the first one to write. Je travaillerai. D'accord. Ah, donc, parce que vous ne travaillez pas maintenant. Julia, je vais enlever le masque. Attention, masque, c'est masculin. Stardust, je vais inviter tous mes amis et ma famille à une fête. Ça, c'est sympathique. Ça, c'est vrai que c'est très, très sympathique. Lisbeth, la première chose que je ferai, sera de sortir dans la rue. Ah, dans la rue principale. Très bien. Muskan, la première chose que je voudrais faire après le coronavirus, c'est rencontrer mes amis. Ah ben oui, c'est normal, Muskan. Luciana Moribé, je voudrais voyager en France. Eh oui, sans le masque, imaginez, formidable. Lanora, je sortirai au club et je danserai. Eh oui, c'est vrai que ça, c'est difficile maintenant. Bombville Lover, bonjour. Je vais avoir une fête avec toute ma famille. famille. Oui. Feisty Meidar, je voyagerai à nouveau. Eh ouais, ça c'est vrai que c'est important. Cosmina Bellou, quand la pandémie sera finie, j'aimerais voyager. Pas de deux, hein, Cosmina. Red Escarvirel, je vais voyager. Tout le monde veut voyager. Sundar, je vais rencontrer mes amis. Eh oui, ça c'est important. Victoria Jacques, je vais acheter un billet d'avion pour la France. C'est vrai que Victoria, et vous allez au Franprix direct. Et c'est pas pour acheter du fromage, nous savons. Renato, la première chose que je ferai sera de voyager. Patricia, je vais voyager à Philadelphie. Rupa, je vais acheter des vêtements. Donc c'est la frustration de ne pas acheter de vêtements actuellement. Omar, la première chose sera de chercher des tickets pour les vacances. Eh oui, et vous pourrez partir en famille. Hillary, la première chose que je vais faire quand le virus aura disparu, je vais sortir de la maison. La simple possibilité de sortir, c'est incroyable. Yann Arte, je voudrais manger au restaurant, c'est vrai. Bickert, je vais voir mes amis, je vais au parc, je me promène tous les jours dehors. Yossi, je veux inviter ma famille chez moi pour fêter la fin du Covid-19. C'est vrai, un repas en famille, ça c'est sympathique. Vouslat, je vais aller rendre visite à mon frère, et ça c'est bien aussi. Yessero, la première chose que je vais faire, c'est sauter avec joie. Comme ça, et aller au concert avec beaucoup de gens. Oui, c'est vrai, un concert sans les masques et on peut danser. Vercingétorix, la première chose que je vais aller faire serait de rendre visite à mes parents qui vivent trop loin de chez moi. Et ça, c'est vrai, c'est très bien. Yasmine, la première chose que je ferai sera de voyager en Andorre. Très bien. Dessarlika, la première chose que je ferai sera de travailler encore, ou à nouveau peut-être. Alina, je vais voyager à Helsinki, très bien. Cheryline, je vais sortir le week-end pour le plaisir et voir mes amis en dehors du laboratoire. Ah oui, c'est vrai. Vous êtes dans le laboratoire en ce moment. Ice Cubes nous rejoint. Bonsoir, bonjour Ice Cubes. Jamie, je vais faire une randonnée. Très bien. Chiquita Paul, je vais manger au restaurant avec ma famille. Bah écoutez, c'est formidable. Merci beaucoup en tout cas, c'était très bien. Alors, Ice Cubes avec du retard, mais on va la prendre quand même. Je vais acheter un billet d'aller dans une autre partie du monde. Mais où ? On ne sait pas. On ne sait pas. Alors, you know that at this level, usually we're doing the numbers, okay? So, well, this concept is extremely simple. I will just dictate some numbers and you just need to write them. Alors, let's start with the first one. So I will read it twice, and then of course, this one will be quite simple because you will have only two digits, okay? So just get ready. On y va. 85, 85. So now you can write the numbers. 85. Alors, Alice is joining us. Bonjour, Alice. You can participate. We're doing the dictations of numbers right now. Ice Cube is the first one, so she was late, but now she's back on the track. Très bien. Be careful, Muskan. So, Luke and Bourneville Lover, you were a bit too generous, the two of you. 85, remember. So, 80, it's 80. So, 8 and 0. And in that case, you just need to add the 5 after 85, 85, 8 et 5. Iris, bonsoir, bonsoir, bonsoir. Mouskan, ah, j'ai fait une faute. C'est pas grave. Allez, numéro 2. So it's the second one in that case. We will have 3 digits. D'accord, 3 digits. So let's go for it. Same thing here, I will read it only 2 times. Hein. 792. 792. So can you write it? Oh la 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 la, hey, Ice Cube, she will be the first one now. It will be one of these days. She's extremely efficient. 792, so far so good. I'm looking at your answers, but everything seems to be quite good, in fact. So remember that the way it goes, 100, it's 100. So after that, you will put 7. 700 will be 700. Then the second part that is a bit tricky, 90, remember, it's 90. 92 will be 92. 792. 792, that's the number, I mean, I was expecting to see. And so far, so good. Rupa, I guess you're a bit, you're not synchronized. So maybe when you hear that, refresh your stream and you will see that it will be good. D'accord? Allez, let's continue with the third number. So as you can see here, of course, we're doing that in a rational way. So now we've got 4 digits. So listen and write, same thing, only twice. So 9032. 9032. Write the number. Alors, un grand merci à Kaiva qui m'offre un café. So you're offering me a coffee. It's so nice. So nice. And I drink a lot of coffee. Even if this morning was a bit challenging because I didn't have coffee in the morning. It was so difficult. But thanks to you, I can have coffee all the time. Alors, let's look at the numbers that you're writing. And so far, so good. Yes. So look, we agree that 1,000 is 1000, so in that case it was 9000, and then I didn't have anything for the 100, so basically it was 9000 and then 9032, so 9032. But so far so good, congratulations. Be careful, Yann, you've been putting the thing in the wrong order, so it was not 9302. Same thing for Sean Douglas, hein? Be careful, it was 9032. D'accord? Allez, let's continue, and it will be the last one for this series of numbers. So obviously this one will be the trickiest one because you will have 5 digits. So let's start, and same thing here, I will just read it twice. 96340. 96340. 40. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Oh, Jezebel is so nice with me. She's saying, Vincent, you're a very good and nice French teacher. Merci, Jezebel. It's so nice. Merci beaucoup. Alors, let's have a look at the numbers. Now, it's arriving. And, well, I think, did I see? Yeah, it's Ice Cubes. Huh? Ice Cubes, she's the first one now for everything. So, Sherilyn, you need to be faster. Julia, too. Cosmina Bellu, too. Victoria, ja. Come on, let's try to challenge Ice Cubes. It will be fun. Alors, in that case, it was 96,000. So remember, 1,000 is 1,000, so 96 and then 1,000. I assume she's doing the... the dance, the victory dance, la danse de la victoire. And after that, it was 340. 96,340. Très bien. Well, it was quite good, in fact. Félicitations. Let's see the next thing. But once again, please click on the like. I would like to have as many likes as possible. Alors, everyone is complaining about their connections, but, and of course Ice Cube is saying, oh, it's over, too bad, I was the first one. Allez, could you please tell me what does she say? Alors, que dit-elle? Just imagine one sentence to tell me what she says. Qu'est-ce qu'elle dit? Allez-y. Alors, Vercingétorix qui is the first one to say ne m'appelle pas et ne m'écris pas. It was almost perfect, Vercingétorix, because you are and I am a purist. So remember that because you're using this imperative form. So the first verb was perfect. Appel, you don't put the S, it's perfect. But then remember that écrit, you should write it E-C-R-I-S. Because it's foutu, remember. So ne m'écris with the S and not the T. Pas. But it was perfect otherwise. Phonetically, it was good. Yesero, elle dit qu'elle a... Alors, attendez. Qu'elle a plus que marre de porter des masques. C'est vrai. Vouslat, j'en ai marre de ce virus. Stardust, elle dit non, la nourriture est à nouveau brûlée. Ah, c'est quelqu'un qui cuisine d'une façon originale. Mouscane, pourquoi tu ne portes pas ton masque? Pourquoi? You forgot the quoi, maybe? Lanora, je sens quelque chose de puant. C'est bizarre comme phrase, Lanora. Ok. Ensuite, je regarde Chiquita qui nous dit où est mon masque? Remember, Chiquita, that mask is masculine. So it means that you're possessive. Mon should be in the masculine form because it is related to mask. Rupa, elle gronde, d'accord? Mercurial, aimez-vous ma coupe de cheveux? Ah, d'accord. But she looks a bit angry, I don't know. Ensuite, alors attendez, I'm lost. C'est bon, Victoria Jacques, elle dit, les gens pensent que je suis en colère, mais je pense vraiment au vin. Victoria Jacques, I'm not sure it's possible to have one lesson without mentioning this magical drink. Je ne sais pas. Vickert, tu m'inquiètes pas. Julia, vraiment avec cette coupe de cheveux, je ressemble à un garçon. Attention, Julia, c'était pas garçon, mais c'est garçon. Omar, je suis énervé avec ce temps. Eh oui, Cosmina Bellou, elle est très fière parce qu'elle est enceinte et sa grossesse fait d'elle une vraie lionne. Eh oui, il faut jamais contrarier les femmes enceintes. On le sait. Yesero, alors attendez, ça discute. Lisbeth, elle dit qu'elle doit faire la vaisselle aujourd'hui. Ok, ça explique la réaction des Sarlika. Elle n'est pas contente car elle n'est pas la première. Eh oui, Cherylyn. Alors attendez, Cherylyn, je vous ai perdu. Ouh, il y a beaucoup de gens qui participent. Oui, on ne peut pas se tutoyer. Eh oui, on ne se tutoie pas dès la première fois. Hilary, elle dit « je marche sur la gomme ». Hein? Hilary, I understand all the words, but I'm not sure I get the concept, Hilary. Yossi, elle dit, j'ai oublié de prendre un masque avec moi. Eh oui, ça m'est arrivé l'autre jour. Luciada, elle dit, pourquoi personne n'a cliqué, hein, une personne a cliqué sur dislike. Oh, c'est normal, Luciana. C'est normal. Iris, tu es d'accord avec moi? Renato, le professeur Vincent est toujours en retard. Alors non, Renato, let me explain to you the way it works. At the university, we have what we call the 15 minutes. So it's possible during the 15 first minutes to arrive when we want. We call that le quart d'heure académique. Science nous dit, fais-moi confiance, je suis sympathique. Sundar, elle dit, quand le coronavirus va finir. Ensuite, Roman qui nous dit, Roman, elle est fâchée parce qu'elle dit... qu'elle a dit qu'elle ne pouvait pas passer le test. Eh oui. Tamika, qu'est-ce que tu fais là? Ice Cubes, elle semble ennuyée d'avoir envoyé le projet avec une petite erreur comme je l'ai fait. Ça arrive. Elle dit que je devrais à nouveau préparer les plans. Oh, ah oui, vous êtes perfectionniste. Oui, d'accord. Mohamed, bonjour. Comment allez-vous? Victoria Jacques, toujours du vin. Alors, très bien. Et après, ça discute. Hein. Tout le monde discute. Merci beaucoup, en tout cas. Alors, Olga nous rejoint. Bonjour, Olga. Vous arrivez pour le verbe. So, you are right on time for the conjugation. Yeah. The verb of the day, as you remember, we conjugate one verb. Today, it will be nager. So, nager, it's an interesting verb because basically, well, it means to swim. So, it's a verb from the first group. So, remember, the verbs ending with er are, in fact, quite easy to conjugate. But you need to remember that all the verbs that will end with this G-E-R will be tricky for nous. And so we will see that together. So we agree that here you have the three moods and you have all the tenses that normally you should master if you want to reach this advanced level. But for us, we will only concentrate on these five tenses. So futur proche, présent, futur simple, passé composé, and then passé récent. So of course, we will start with the present tense. Alors be careful, don't be too fast. Okay, well, you started. You know the rule. So yes, we will start with je, but don't give me the next form, the next tense right after. Just wait one little second. Merci. Ice Cubes qui dit, je viens de recevoir un mail qui dit super boulot, alors je laisse tel quel. Et Ice Cubes, I hope it's not a house and then you've been forgetting something and at one point the house will collapse. Hein? Attention. Alors, let's have a look at your forms. It's quite good, in fact. So, we agree that in that case, it's not really tricky. It's je nage. So, remember, the ending will be so, this is simple. As I told you, when it comes to the present, the only tricky form will be for the nous person. So this is the reason why now, before switching and going to the other tense, I just would like you to take 1 second to give me the nous form of nager in the present tense. Allez-y. Alors, Tenzin is joining us. Bonjour, Tenzin. Remember to click on the like hein, before starting to write the conjugation. Merci. Alors, félicitations. Be careful, Hilary. It's not E, but it's E. D'accord? So I've been putting that in red just to make it sure that you can visualize it more easily. So basically, the only thing that we will have to add, so basically it means that we will change slightly the grammatical rule, because normally we should not put this E, but then for phonetical reasons, because basically if you don't put it, you will get the sound nous nagons, and clearly I cannot make any connection with the infinitive, the verb nager. So this is the reason why we will have to keep it or to add this E to keep the sound je. Nageons. So nous nageons, remember, you will just have to put this extra E after your G. D'accord? But I mean, it was quite good. There was only Hilary or other persons. Remember, just not the E, but the E. D'accord? Allez, let's continue now with the futur proche de l'indicatif. Remember, it's this near future concept. We use the verb aller in the present, and after that, you just need to put the infinitive. As usual, I'm expecting the je. S'il vous plaît, go for it. Alors, and this time is Vercingétorix, the king of the Franks, remember, first king of French people, so we need to respect him, and it was really good, so we agree that the verb is aller, you conjugate that in the present form, so it's je vais, d'accord, and then you just need to put the infinitive, so nager, je vais nager, I am going to swim, we're talking about the near future and something that is certain, so you are going to do it. Allez, let's have a look at the real future now, so this future simple form. So how could you put the je form for nager in the future simple? Alors, and this time, this is Cosmina Bellou. Cosmina Bellou is always fast, but now she's been probably refreshing her stream, and she's back to be the first. So we agree that in that situation, the way to get the root, to get the stem, in fact, is extremely simple. You just need to keep the infinitive. So you take your infinitive, and after that, you will just put the ending that goes for the person. In that situation, je, ending for je in the future simple is AI. So you put your infinitive, then the ending, and you end up with your form nagerai. Okay, je nagerai. We don't emphasize on the E right after the G, and so it's nagerai. Be careful, Olga. Olga, you've been writing with the S. Remember, with the S, it will be for the conditionnel présent. D'accord? And this is the mistake that usually people make. So in that case, it's futur simple. And futur simple, the ending will be AI. D'accord? Conditionnel présent, AIS, but it's another thing. Allez, let's have a look at the passé récent. Remember, the passé récent, it's this possibility to express something that just happened. So the way we construct that in French is the verb venir, to come. In the present, you put your preposition de, and after that, the infinitive. And it's really to express something that just happened. Allez, write me please the je form of nager in this passé récent. Alors, so far so good. Everything that I see arriving on the screen is extremely good. So, the verb venir, hein, this is the little tricky thing, is to conjugate venir. But in that situation, everything had the correct form. So it's je viens, V-I-E-N-S. D'accord? Je viens is the form for je. And then, as I told you, you put the preposition de, je viens de, and you just put your verb right after nager. You don't touch it. Infinitive form. Je viens de nager. So you really express something that just happened. So let's agree on that. It's not something that can be used if the thing happened maybe 1 month ago or 1 year ago. It won't be this recent past. You will go for passé composé, and by the way, lucky you, this is exactly what we are about to see now. Passé composé, remember, passé composé, it's the most common past tense that we will use because we are talking about events. So it's a compound tense, so it means that we will have first to use a helping verb. We have only two options. In most of the cases, it will be avoir, and in some exceptions, it will be être. And then the second part will be the past participle. So try to give me the passé composé form of nager, s'il vous plaît. Oh yeah, it's true, you're 99 and I've got only 77 likes. It's not reasonable. If everybody can click, I would be so pleased. So pleased, otherwise I will cry like a little baby and you will be embarrassed and me too. Alors, oui, très très bien, hein? So far so good, no problem. So we agree that in that situation, the verb nager is not really tricky because we are using the avoir as a helping verb, like in most of the cases. So it must be in the present, d'accord? So it will be j'ai. So this is the form that you will first put. And then you put your past participle. Past participle of the verbs from the first group, it's a piece of cake because basically you pronounce it the same as the infinitive and you just need to remove the final R and you put the accent on your E. So, j'ai nagé, d'accord? J'ai nagé. So this is the passé composé form. Alors, que se passe-t-il? Lucas Meia, what are you doing? I will just block you. Sorry about that, Lucas. Try to find another place to have some fun. Au revoir, Lucas. Allez, let's continue. Alors, as I told you, today I wanted to work on verbs, and then verbs that will end in G, G-E-R, d'accord? So this is the time, if you want to have some help, to open the other tab, to have a look at the dictionary, if you want to do it like that. It's a way to be proactive. Hein? If you don't know the thing, you can look for it. I mean, it's not a problem. In fact, it's quite good. So remember, the exercise is always the same. We'll have to translate some verbs, but I only want verbs ending with G-E-R. D'accord? Not the other ones. Allez, let's start with the first one. The first one, it's this one to abbreviate. How could you say that in French? Remember, I want a verb ending with G-E-R. Christian Kerk is joining us. Bonjour, you can participate. Alors, as usual, Julia is offering some verbs that we can offer to the French Academy, because this one is not, it doesn't exist yet. It might be something that could enter the dictionary in, well, for the next year. In that case, the verb that we were looking for was, in fact, abrégé, d'accord? You see, I only want verbs ending with G. This is the exercise here. So, raccourcir could be an option in some situations, but then it ends with IR, so I would not like to have it with abrégé. If you don't know the verbs that we are about to discover, make a list, because you will see that, I mean, it's quite interesting. They're not so rare. Well, this one is maybe not a verb that you use every day. Let's agree on that. But numéro 2, allez, to lighten. How could you say that in French? Alors, I can see that this one is interesting. It seems that, d'accord, look at that. The idea, yeah, be careful with the, we're not talking about the light in that case. We're talking about the weight of something. So basically, it's allégé. Allégé, don't forget to put the accent aigu on the first E, d'accord. Donc, allégé will be to lighten. And now I can see that everybody is off. Offering the proper translation. Merci beaucoup. So remember, all these G verbs will behave exactly in the same way as we had for nager when we conjugate. So it means that for the new form, we will have to keep the E, remember, and then we put this O and S to keep the sound. So nous allégeons will be written G. E-O-N-S. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, to extend. To extend, how could you say that in French? Remember, I want a verb ending with G-E-R. Allez-y. Alors, Julia is asking, so it's possible for the weight to be lightened. Well, if you're talking about the calorie, for instance, in most of the cases, you can see as an adjective allégé. So if you're talking about creams, yogurt, and things like that. So this is usually the verb or the adjective that will be used. Alors, to extend, in that case, it's allongé. Oui, félicitations. Yesero has it. Cosmina, rallongé. We could accept it. Prolongé. Oui, Cherylyn, in some cases, it could be possible. You see, prolongé, rallongé. Then, allongé is an option. So we agree that prolongé, allongé, or then rallongé would be totally acceptable. So, félicitations, this is really good. Allez, numéro 4, to develop, to convert to convert or to arrange. What verb could well be the translation for these verbs? Alors. Bon, arranger, I could accept it because yes, we have ranger, arrange in the list. Aménager would be an option too. So I wanted you to go. Yeah, Cosmina Bellou, you went there. I was on that track. Arranger would be acceptable, but you will see that it will come right after. It was just to give you another option. Canita is giving us organiser would be good. Hein? So organiser would be an option. Arranger would be another option. And then aménager as I offered to. Très bien. Srinivas is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Développer, Olga. Oui, in same thing. Développer would be an option, but then, unfortunately, Olga, the idea of the exercise is to find some verbs ending with G. So it's just to try to discover maybe other verbs that you would not find in the first place. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, and you see the reason why. I was waiting for something else in the previous one. How can you translate to arrange? Allez-y. Alors, it's Ice Cube. Ice Cube is back, hein, because now, yeah. And she's even doing the choreography. Versailles-Gétorix, right after, Yesero is there. So yes, of course, in that case, hein, so I was expecting arranger, so we agree that it was possible to use it before, but in that case, it's the only option, let's put it that way. So now, numéro 6. Numéro 6, to benefit. Alors, to benefit, how could you, translate that in French? Remember, I want a verb ending with G. Très bien. MS Heart Herb 83 is joining us. Bonjour. Just find something. Yes, don't be scared, because I can see that you're 109 persons right now, and I've got only 83 likes. It's not reasonable at all. If you want to please me, if you want to make me happy, click on the like button, s'il vous plaît. Merci. Alors, to benefit, avantager would be an option, yes, because this is the one that I had. Let me look at the things. Ranger, not really des Arlica. Ranger, it would be something different, but avantager was, to my point of view, maybe the best option. I don't see anything else. So basically, you were exactly going in the same direction as me. So let's agree that this will be avantager, the verb that we will take for to benefit. Let's look at numéro 7. Visois, salut. Remember to click on the like and you can participate. To move. How could you say that? To move. Thank you. Alors, it's interesting because Vercingétorix is going for Ménager. I would not go for that, Vercingétorix. Sherilyn, yes, I would go in the same direction as you. So, I was expecting more this bouger concept. Hein? So, in that situation, you're talking about a person. Je bouge, an animal. Something is moving. Hein? Un objet bouge, se déplace. Well, I think it would be better with bouger. Mich Micha, bonjour, bonjour. Don't forget to click on the like. And let's try to hope that I can have 100 likes before the end. So bouger would be the best option. Furzy, déranger. Not really, because déranger, it's to disturb. It's really to disturb. And I think it's coming not in this exercise, but in the next one. D'accord? So, numéro 8, to challenge. To challenge, how could you say that in French? And you will see that, well, you will see. Alors, Roman, déplacer, non, because remember that the exercise is to only find verbs ending with G. Alors, it's really interesting because Namal is offering défier. And yes, it would be the perfect translation. And personally, I would go for this one because défier is the original, un défi défier. But let's agree on that. And it's true that nowadays people talk more about un challenge than un défi. You can regret it, you can think whatever you want about it, but still, this is the reality. And you can also hear the verb challenger. So basically, it's coming from English. This is what we call a neologism, something that is new in the language. And in most of the cases, all these verbs are belonging to the first group. All the new verbs will be introduced and then they will be in the first category. So basically, it's extremely simple to conjugate. This is a good thing. So challenger is the translation and the thing that we are using. Défier would be great, but then it doesn't belong to this category of verbs. Okay, so let's have a look at numéro 9. Numéro 9, and it's easy. It's really easy. You can find it without looking in your dictionary. So, to change, how could you say that into French? Alors, be curt is the first one. Bravo, be curt. Félicitations. And yes, it is changer. So as you can see, it's not, well, that difficult or that different. Remember, once again, and these verbs ending with G will be tricky in the present. For the new form, you will have to keep the E after your G to get the correct sound. Changeons, nous changeons. So far, so good. Everyone wrote something good. Estina is writing her or his name. And it's good, but it was a verb. We were hoping to see a verb, Estina. Allez, let's have a look at the numéro 10. And yes, 2 likes, please. Just 2 likes. See if you like. Click on it. And we can have this 100 thing complete. Allez, to load. To load, how could you say that in French? Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Voilà, and Yesero is the first one. Félicitations, Yesero. Félicitations. So the verb is chargé. And it's really good. Hein? So far, so good. Chargé. Très, très bien. So same thing here. Oh, effectivement, Desarlika. Thank you very much for informing us that... So finally, we've been reaching the 100 likes. Merci beaucoup. It is really nice. And now I am relaxed. I can be totally relaxed for the rest of the day. Merci beaucoup. Allez, let's continue with the next exercise. Alors, Clétine Ho is joining us. Coucou à vous. Coucou à vous. So you arrive for the dialogue of the day. Allez, let's start with the dialogue. And one second, because I need to scroll, obviously, to find the first thing. My God, we've been doing a lot. Okay. Allez, so let's have a look at the dialogue and you will see. So normally it should be quite simple. So basically I will read the dialogue. Of course you will have the translation. If you want to look at the translation, it is your choice, your decision. D'accord? If you don't want to look at the translation, in that case, focus only on the French part. I will read it. You have three words to find. The usual. It's not really tricky, d'accord? So we can start with the first thing. And so I will read it twice. Bonjour, excusez-moi de vous déranger. Je peux vous poser une question? Bonjour, excusez-moi de vous déranger. Je peux vous poser une question? Allez, write the missing words. Alors, Clétine Ho, vous parlez portugais? Non, je suis désolé, je ne parle pas portugais. Alors, let's have a look at what you're writing. So far, so good. Yep, be careful. Attendez une seconde. I think it was Stardust. Yeah, Stardust, be careful at your first thing. It was not properly written. So, in that case, look, the first one is the verb excuser or then s'excuser. But in that case, you have the vous form. Was looking and trying to find it. So it's the vous form, so definitely you should end it with a Z. So excusez. Then after that you have a verb. I mean the verb is in the infinitive form, so infinitive is déranger, remember. Accent aigu on the first E if you have it on your keyboard. Déranger. And then the last thing, it was the verb poser, same thing here, it's the infinitive because it comes right after the verb pouvoir, je peux, so it must be in the infinitive form, je peux vous poser, d'accord? Allez, I will read it, you can read it with me if you want. Hein. Bonjour, excusez-moi de vous déranger, je peux vous poser une question. Allez, let's have a look at the second thing. Same thing here. If you don't want to look at the translation, don't look at it. Oui, bien entendu, j'espère simplement pouvoir vous répondre. Oui, bien entendu, j'espère simplement pouvoir vous répondre. Allez-y, write the missing words. Zaki, we don't talk about religion here. No religion, no politics. Sorry about that. There are many other places where you can discuss about politics and religion. Here, we just focus on the language. Alors, in that case, yep, it is really good. Hein? So the first thing, it was entendu. So from what I can see, you've been writing it perfectly. So it should be written E-N-T-E-N-D-U. After that, it's an adverb simplement. Same thing here. I mean, it's really, really well written. So you can be happy because you are working really well now. Simplement, remember, S-I-M-P-L-E-M-E-N-T, d'accord? And the last thing, it's the verb répondre. Hein. Répondre should be definitely in the infinitive. Hein. So, répondre, R-E accent aigu, if you have the accent on your keyboard, P-O-N-D-R-E. Très bien. Juto AMV, bonsoir, bonsoir, you can participate. I will read something, you just need to find the missing words. Oui, je parle français. un petit peu. Allez, let's have a look at the next thing. Same thing here, if you don't want to look at the translation, don't look at it. I'm reading, you find the missing words. Vous savez... À quelle heure ouvre la préfecture? Ça fait 10 minutes que j'attends déjà. Vous savez à quelle heure ouvre la préfecture? Ça fait 10 minutes que j'attends déjà. So write the missing words. Merci beaucoup. Alors, so far so good. Yeah, it's really good what you're writing. So the first thing is obviously quel, and it should be in the feminine form, hein, because heure is feminine. So remember that we need to adapt the thing according to the gender of the word it is connected to. So quel, Q-U-E-L-L-E. D'accord. Ensuite, préfecture. So, préfecture, in most of the cases, we write it with a capital letter. So, it will be, sorry, Zaki. Zaki, no offense, no problem. I will just block you because you don't really participate. Merci beaucoup, Zaki. So, préfecture should be with a masculine, a capital letter. So, capital letter, and then don't forget to put the accent at the beginning of your d'accord, for the first sorry. And then the last thing, it was the verb attendre, attendre, and it should be, well, in the present tense, in that case, it's the first person. So it's attend, A-T-T-E-N-D-S, d'accord, j'attends. Vous savez à quelle heure ouvre la préfecture, ça fait 10 minutes que j'attends déjà. Alors, Ice Cube, c'est impossible de pouvoir lire la traduction. But you're not supposed to look at the translation. This is the reason why. I'm sorry. Je m'excuse. Très bien. Allez, let's have a look at the next thing. So if you don't want to look at the translation or if you can't see the translation, well, don't look at it. Je crois que c'est pas ouvert aujourd'hui à cause de la visite du ministre de l'Intérieur. Je crois que c'est pas ouvert aujourd'hui à cause de la visite du ministre de l'intérieur. Alors, Geront Villagomez is joining us from the Philippines. Bonjour, bonjour, you can participate. Just wait one second and you can participate for the next exercise. Alors oui, c'est bien. Hein? So the first thing is the verb croire. Remember that croire, when you conjugate it in the first person for, well, the masculine, it will be, the present, sorry. It will be je crois, C-R-O-I-S, je crois. After that, it's aujourd'hui. Aujourd'hui can be tricky to write, but so far, no, it's quite good. You don't make any mistakes, so it's really good. Félicitations. So remembered, so it will go like A-U-J-O-U-R-D apostrophe H-U-I. Aujourd'hui. And the last thing, it was intérieur. Hein? Le ministre de l'intérieur. Intérieur, you will write it like I-N. Remember, it's a nasal, so everything is going in the nose. You don't pronounce any N. Un. Intérieur. Le ministre de l'intérieur. Très bien. So let's read the thing one more time. Je crois que c'est pas ouvert aujourd'hui à cause de la visite du ministre de l'intérieur. Voilà, voilà. Well, I hope it was okay for you, at least. I think you were doing, I mean, you've been doing a really, really great job because you didn't make a lot of mistakes, so félicitations. Now it's my time to click on like for you. Merci. Allez. Oh, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Yes, I am. Okay, the picture of the day. And this is the picture of the day. I thought it was interesting. And I don't really know what you could write, in fact. And this is the beauty about it. We will discover everything that you can come up with. So please, one sentence to describe or then to comment this picture, this photo. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Alors, Shigita nous dit les couleurs de la vie, peut-être. Ça, c'est bien. Hillary qui dit « Je ne coupe pas !» D'accord. Ensuite, Jamie qui nous dit « Je ne sais pas coudre !» D'accord. Vouslat qui dit « J'aime bien coudre des vêtements !» That's the beauty about it. We're so different. Hein? This is the beauty about that. Namal, cette photo montre des ciseaux bleus et des fils différents de différentes couleurs. Très bien. Yossi, c'est un grand magasin de couture. Stardust, les couleurs des fils sont très belles. J'aimerais bien voir les tissus. Ah oui, c'est vrai. Ça pourrait être intéressant de voir les tissus qui vont avec. Yesero, je vois une photo qui montre des ciseaux et des couleurs de l'arc-en-ciel. Kositzer, merci Vincent, je suis malade aujourd'hui. Non. Alors j'espère que ça n'est pas le Covid. il faut rester au lit, il faut boire du thé très chaud et il faut dormir, dormir et dormir. Mercurial, un ciseau ou des ciseaux pour couper à... Pour les coupes les tours, je ne sais pas ce que ça veut dire. I'm not really sure I'm following you. I don't really get it. Luciana, il y a beaucoup de fils de couleurs différents. Faites attention, fil, F-I-L-S. Des ciseaux attendent à couper les... Waouh, attendez, les fils. Alors, ensuite, elle gardait son fil et ses aiguilles dans sa boîte à couture, très bien. Iris, c'est vraiment coloré, oui. Bourville Lover, beaucoup de fils de toutes les couleurs pour la couture, oui. Cheryline, ce sont des matériaux que les souris de Cendrillon ont utilisé pour créer sa robe. Oui, c'est vrai que c'était les souris. Hein. Alors, Jezebel, les ciseaux sont très petits. Faites attention, ciseaux, c'est pluriel. Kanita, j'aime le ton de la couleur. Christmo, il y avait une manufacture qui arrête la production pour le Covid, c'est possible. Julia qui nous dit les ciseaux et des fils. Romande qui nous dit, oups, je vous ai perdu, Romande, voilà, il y a une paire de ciseaux qui serait utilisée pour couper des vêtements. Oui. Omar, le matériel pour faire un foulard. Parfait pour le froid. Tenzin, il y a des ciseaux et beaucoup de fils pour la couture. Géronte, les ciseaux sont importants lors de la confection de vêtements. Magnifiquement écrit. Vercingétorix, si je vous ai coupé de ma vie, c'est sans doute parce que vous m'avez donné des ciseaux. D'accord. Ah, il faudrait expliquer quand même, hein, mais c'est intéressant. Roupa, il y a beaucoup de fils colorés, oui. Olga Ruiz, les couleurs sont très belles. I have hope, il y a des ciseaux et des cordes, des fils, hein, pour la couture. Tserine, il y a des fils multicolores et des ciseaux bleus, oui. Alors attendez, je regarde. Cosmina Bellou, c'est la nouvelle manière d'avoir des cheveux colorés à la maison. Dans des conditions de la pandémie, vous devez découper la couleur préférée et alors, vous mettez comme ça. Ah, c'est une bonne technique. Hein. Pour moi, ce serait très difficile, très très difficile. J'ai pas beaucoup de cheveux. Mich 82. Mich, les ciseaux sont importants dans chaque maison. C'est vrai. Lisbeth, les principaux instruments des mains de l'artisan. Très bien. Yann Arte, la femme de travail pour les vêtements. Ice Cube, c'est comme une image détaillée d'un atelier de ma grand-mère. Oh, ben ça, c'est chouette. Très bien. Sujata, quelqu'un qui prépare un cadeau de Noël. Et Kavia qui nous dit, j'aime la couture, je couds mes vêtements. Très, très bien. Et félicitations. Allez, nous aurons le temps quand même de faire un petit peu de dictée. So, allez, get ready, we'll do the dictation, remember how it goes. I will read some sentences. Same thing here, I will give you also the translation, but if you don't want to look at it, don't look at it, but still it will be on the screen, so don't be surprised. But then if you want to just focus on the sentence, don't look at the sentence that is in the little orange or yellow box at the bottom. D'accord? On y va. It will be the first one and I will read it twice. You just need to write it. Elle veut acheter un cadeau pour sa mère. Elle veut acheter un cadeau pour sa mère. So write the sentence. Merci. « Et bravo Yossi, vous étiez le premier, you were the first one. Alors regardez ici, so obviously the verb was vouloir. Vouloir, when you conjugate it in the present tense. At the third person, you will get the form veut, V-E-T. Elle veut. Second verb should definitely be in the infinitive and it's acheter. Elle veut acheter. Un cadeau. Remember, it can be a bit tricky, this cadeau. In some cases, people can make some mistake. So, C-A-D-E-A-U. And don't forget the E or the A, but it goes like D-E-A-U. And the last part, pour, the preposition, sa mère. We put sa because mère is feminine, so we should put definitely the feminine form. Ça. Elle veut acheter un cadeau pour sa mère. Allez, let's have a look at the second one. I hope you're ready, because we will... So same thing here, if you don't want to look at the translation, don't look at the little box. And that's it. C'est son anniversaire la semaine prochaine. C'est son anniversaire la semaine prochaine. Write the sentence. Alors, très très bien, je vois que vous écrivez des choses formidables. Now, it's really good. It is really good. So, look at your screen to compare, but then everybody has been writing a perfect thing. So, it's really, really, really good. Alors, attendez. Jezebel is asking if I write mère, not mère. Is it wrong? Well, Jezebel, the idea would be to, when we put the accent, especially when it comes, Jezebel, to the accent aigu and accent grave, well, you should write them. If you don't write them with your keyboard because you don't have it on your keyboard, usually it's quite okay. But still, if you need to write, because basically, think about that, when you put the accent, of course, you tend to visualize still the E, but in fact, you pronounce it totally differently, so it is like if it was another vowel, d'accord? So this is the reason why it's quite important to put them, because mère, if you don't put it like that in this case, well, it will be a problem, and in some cases, you don't really want to you know, not put them. So try to memorize them, because it's a part of the you know, the way to memorize the thing. You should definitely put them at one point. So, c'est son anniversaire. So, remember that anniversaire is masculine. So, we'll go for the masculine possessive, son, d'accord? Anniversaire, remember, we've got two N. So, it's something that, well, usually it's not a problem, but still, you need to remember that. After that, semaine is feminine, so it means that the adjective prochaine should be in the feminine form. Remember, masculine is prochain, A-I-N, nasal, un. But then, when you add this E in the end, it will be prochaine. Alors, très bien. Alors, très bien. Je vois, I'm looking at the question of Yossi. And Yossi is asking, quelle est la troisième langue que vous parlez? Well, Yossi, it's not a surprise. The third language that I can speak and I'm using on a daily basis is the language that you will hear in few seconds. And that's it. This is the end of the lesson. Tomorrow we'll continue. It will be intermediate. And after that, it will be advanced. Merci beaucoup. So Yossi, yes, I can speak Finnish. And this is the beauty about this terrible, terrible and difficult language. Merci beaucoup, au revoir et à demain. See you tomorrow.
Seistyksin yksin parvekkeen kaiteella. Alla maailma, jonne et tahdo palata. Suurin ongelma on, ettei ole ongelmaa. Tarpeeksi soha, joka allen sinut musertaa. Sen reunan ja asetut roikkumaan niin, et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni. Ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni.